The Philippines is losing 1.3 trillion pesos or about $26.9 billion a year due to China's island building and clam poaching activities in the West Philippine Sea. That's according to Jerwin Baure, a member of a group of scientists and environmentalists called Agham. Baure says China's aggression in the West Philippine Sea accounts for most of the documented reef destruction in the area. They arrived at the cost of damage of after multiplying the current estimate of coral reefs destroyed within the economic with the economic value of coral reefs, which is at $350,000 per hectare a year. Should China be fined for this, Baure says it could be made to pay at least 1.92 trillion pesos if the amount will be based on the compensation that the U.S. paid the Philippines after it caused damage at the Tubataha Reef. Philippine Senator slammed President Rodrigo Duterte's defeatist statements about Chinese incursions in the West Philippine Sea. They say the country's chief executive should not be the first to surrender any part of the Philippine territory. Joyce Balancia reports.
Even if you go there and give, wala rin mangyari kasi kanila talaga para sa isip nila kanila. The issue of the West Philippine Sea remains to be a question forever until such time that we can take it back. We can retake it only by force. There is no way that we can get back the tawag nilang Philippine Sea without any bloodshed.
Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte himself admitted China is still in possession of the West Philippine Sea despite a ruling by the Hague Arbitral Court in 2016 that settled the status of the West Philippine Sea. Defense Chief Delfin Lorenzana said there is nothing blocking the Philippine ships in patrolling the waters, but Duterte insisted he cannot just order the Chinese ships to leave the waters. Recently, hundreds of Chinese vessels were spotted lingering in the West Philippine Sea, triggering fears that they could be amassing a great deal of marine resources in the area, leaving Filipino fishermen with little catch these past days. Duterte said he will allow Chinese to fish in the West Philippine Sea, but he won't permit China to drill oil and other marine resources.
Sinabi ko naman sa inyo sa Chinese government, I'm not so much interested now in fishing. I don't think there's enough fish really to worry about. But when we start to mine, when we start to get whatever it is in the bowels of the China Sea, sa ating oil, dyan ako. But by that time, I will send my ships there.
The chief executive also made it appear that he is not interested in addressing the incident where a news team from ABS-CBN was chased off by Chinese maritime militia in the West Philippine Sea recently.
Hindi ngayon na yung pahabul-habulan lang dyan. Ano ba naman? Habulin yung isang reporter na ano. Ngayon kung habulan na ng maghabulan lang sila dyan, sige, bigyan ko sila ng limang coast guard. Habul-habulan lang nila dyan, maglaro sila. Kung sino ang mas mabilis.
He also lambasted retired Supreme Court Associate Justice Antonio Carpio when the latter said that the government is not doing enough to stop China.
Ito naman si Carpio. Daldal ng daldal. Wala namang, ano bang gusto mo? I'll ask you a question. If the United Nations will ask China to surrender because of that award given to us, ibibigay ba ng China yan?
Carpio said securing a resolution from the United Nations is already a big victory since it means that many countries are supporting the Philippines. Opposition Senator Rizzo Hontivero said it is shameful that the Commander-in-Chief himself, who has not yet done jet skiing the West Philippine Sea as he promised, is the one leading the move to surrender part of our territory to China. Senator Panfilo Lacson also stressed that as the country's leader, Duterte should be speaking about anything except surrender because there could be serious implications to the Philippine sovereignty. The palace spokesman, on the other hand, clarified that the chief executive is not surrendering any part of the country's territory.
I think on the contrary, hindi nagbibigay ang presidente sa China. He made it very clear. Kaibigan tayo, makikipagkaibigan ako, but there is a limit to our friendship. I don't give at all anything to China. I think he just made it very clear na may limit at may hangganan ang pagkakaibigan.
Philippine Ambassador to the United States Jose Manuel Romualdez said the Washington will help Manila in addressing Chinese incursions in the West Philippine Sea.
We are working round the clock, so to speak, in terms of being able to navigate or make sure that there's the freedom of the seas and that freedom code of conduct that we're pushing. At the same time, the United States is obviously waiting for us to call them if we need their assistance in removing or asking the vessels that are parked in our area of responsibility or economic zone.
Meanwhile, Duterte said he is willing to leave his post if he does not have any more the support of the military. This as rumors are spreading that there is a plot for retired and active military officers to unseat the president because of their discontent on how he is handling the issue with China.
If I cannot have the cooperation of the armed forces, then there's no point in working for this government. Hola.
Earlier, Defense Secretary Delfin Lorenzana and AFP Chief of Staff Cirilito Sobihana denied that there is any destabilization plot against the president. Joyce Balancho, ABS-CBN News.